Okay, dear students, let us start with another question. So, see the A part of the 8th question. Why two electric lines of force cannot intersect each other? Two electric lines of force, they cannot intersect each other because if they did, then at the point of intersection, there will be two directions of the electric field. That means if a charge is placed over there, it would be able to go in both the directions, because let us say positive charge is placed at a particular point, we know it experiences the force in the direction of the electric field. So if the two electric field lines are intersecting at a point, in that condition the positive charge would have the choice to go in any one of the direction. That is not possible because it can go only in one direction. In fact, the fact is that in case, let us say, take for an example, we have got a positive charge here and another positive charge over here. If we consider some point P, let us say over here, so this positive charge would produce an electric field away from it at point P in this direction. Let us call it charge Q1 and electric field due to this E1. And similarly, this positive charge, let us call it Q2, a positive charge again at point P would produce an electric field in this direction. Let us call it E2. So it will appear as if these two electric fields are intersecting at this particular point P. No, they are not. In fact, these two together would produce one single resultant electric field, which will be given by the vector sum of these two electric fields. So please remember, two electric lines of force can never intersect each other, because if they did, then at the point of intersection, there will be two directions of electric field, which is not possible. Now coming to the B part of the question. Does an electric dipole always experience a torque when placed in a uniform electric field? So we know that uniform electric field is represented by parallel and equally separated arrows all pointing in the same direction. So, and what is an electric dipole? Electric dipole is a system of two equal and opposite charges separated by some vector distance. So let us say this is plus Q and this is minus Q charge over here. Now this plus Q charge would experience force given by plus Q into E vector in the direction of electric field, and this will experience a force of minus Q into E vector, that is a force in the direction opposite to the direction of electric field. Now, as far as the expression of the torque is concerned, we know that torque is given by PE sin theta. Torque is given by PE sin theta. Of course, in the vector form, if we want to represent, it is P vector cross product E vector. Okay, let us come to the magnitude form. So, torque expression is PE sin theta. P is the electric dipole moment, E is the electric field, and theta is the angle between the direction of electric field and the direction of electric dipole moment. So here in case we want to find out the angle between them, it is this angle theta. So you people can easily see that in case these two values are existing, that is they are non-zero, then for all the values of theta for which sine theta is not equal to zero, there will be torque. So are there certain angles for which sine of theta is equal to 0? Yes. So angle theta when it is equal to 0 degree, we know that sine of 0 degree is equal to 0. Also at the same time, sine of 180 degree is also equal to 0. So our question was, does electric dipole always experience the torque when placed in a uniform electric field? In all other angles, it is true that it will be experiencing the torque, but only for two angles, that is when electric dipole is directed along the direction of electric field or it is exactly in the opposite direction. In that condition, the value of the torque on the electric dipole would be 0. So is that okay? Please remember that. P is sine theta. So for the values of theta, for which sine theta value is 0, the dot value will be 0. Now coming to the C part of the question. So what is the net force on the electric dipole when it is placed in a uniform electric field? The same situation was applicable. We have got a uniform electric field again, and we have got an electric dipole plus Q over here, experiencing the force Q into E towards the right in the direction of electric field, and we have got minus Q charge over here, experiencing the same value of force in the opposite direction. So, since the electric field is uniform, both these forces are equal in magnitude, but they are in the opposite direction. So, obviously, the net value of the force on the electric dipole when it is placed in a uniform electric field is 0. Is that clear? All right. Okay, dear students, come to the D part of the question. What orientation of an electric dipole in a uniform electric field corresponds to its stable equilibrium? Now, if we have a uniform electric field like this, it will be represented like this. Now, coming to equilibrium, what is the meaning of equilibrium? There are two kinds of equilibrium. One is translational equilibrium, for which the net force is required to be zero. Another is rotational equilibrium, for which the torque is required to be zero. Now, as far as uniform electric field is concerned, if we have a dipole placed in it, so its positive charge experiences the force Q into E in the direction of electric field, and its negative charge Q experiences the same force but in the opposite direction. So, an electric dipole placed in a uniform electric field always is in the translational equilibrium. Now, coming to, for it to be in a rotational equilibrium, the value of the torque is required to be 0. And that we have seen in two orientations. That is, for theta is equal to 0 degree and for theta is equal to 180 degree, it will be in rotational equilibrium also. That means for translational as well as both the rotational equilibrium to exist, the electric dipole should be in orientation of either 0 degree or 180 degree. Is that point clear? But they are asking us, in the stable equilibrium, please remember, for the electric dipole to be in the stable equilibrium, the angle has to be 0 degree. It is in equilibrium at an angle of 180 degree also, but equilibrium corresponding to this angle is called unstable equilibrium. We will be subsequently discussing that in this orientation, that is corresponding to 0 degree orientation, this equilibrium is called stable equilibrium, and in this condition the potential energy corresponding to the electric dipole is the lowest, whereas in this condition the electrostatic potential energy associated with the electric dipole is maximum. So for it to be stable equilibrium, the orientation has to be 0 degree. Please remember that. Now coming to the E part and the last part of this question, we have a small electric dipole. So minus Q here and plus Q over here, and we want to find out the ratio of electric field on the axial line. So this is the axial line, that is along the direction of the electric dipole, and another line that we are talking about is the equatorial line. Let us say it is the equatorial line here, and the value of electric field on the equatorial line is represented by EA. So for the situation when this value is very small, that is distance from minus Q to plus Q is very small compared to this distance of this point E over here, which is, let us say, represented by R. So in that condition, the electric field on the axial line is given by 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 2p upon R cube. So direction is not asked, so I'm not mentioning. If direction is asked, you will put the vector sign over here and you will put the vector sign over here also. And electric field in case of the axial line is along the direction of electric dipole moment, getting over here it is towards right. Now coming to on the equatorial line, the electric field is in this direction, and electric field on the equatorial line is represented by 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught p divided by r cube, where r is the distance again from the center of the dipole up to this point, let us say p dash. Now they are asking us what is the ratio between these two. It is very very simple. You can see E axial divided by E equatorial, it will be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught 2p upon r cube divided by 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught p upon r cube. So it is nothing but 2 is to 1. So that is our answer. So I hope you found it very very simple, and in the next video I'll be covering some more interesting and important questions for your exams. All the best. Bye bye till then.